Hi everyone, good morning. I'm Michael from IronSource. I'm regional lead for IronSource company. Before here, I was working at Ekbolani as a business development lead. I'm leading the NA, APAC and EMEA business development teams. It was a wider area for me, but right now I'm focused on the Turkish market and trying to help Turkish developer studios to improve themselves and get a successful business out of their games. So first of all, I want to thank Hyper Games Conference team for this event. It's really exciting to have face-to-face events. I hope we will not get back to home with COVID. But it's good to see a lot of faces here. So today I will talk about skills into the level with in-app bidding. Probably most of you heard bidding before, but today I will try to deep dive a bit and try to explain you how you can get maximum out of it. So my agenda is I will start with a brief intro about IronSource, then I will try to explain how in-app bidding works. And hybrid waterfall setup, which is essential, and how you guys can start in-app bidding, and then I will finish my presentation with success story from Unico Studio, which is also Turkish but located in the NA. IronSource is just go public in the New York Stock Exchange, and IronSource focus is help app developers, not only gaming, we are also active in the non-gaming side, help app developers to grow their business and turn it into successful businesses. This is important because it's not always the case. Having a good game doesn't mean good business. So in that stage, I just come into the stage and help you to grow your app and turn into business. I will start with the evolution of ad monetization optimization. I will give you a brief history about how things started. I guess 10 years ago, probably this is the first time that Adcolony founded the rewarded ads. And there is single networks to use ad monetization. So basically, you implement the ad unit and then set that ad unit specific, probably one ad network, through the revenue share model. Then technology developed and publishers started to sell their inventory to a couple of networks, but still it is on the revenue share, and on that side some flat prices, floor prices come into the picture. But still, it's not so efficient because you are only selling your inventory to four networks and revenue share and flat in CPMs. So you cannot cover all the CPMs to maximize your revenue. Then publishers and networks started to make special deals to maximize return of ad monetization. Then multiple instances come into good place. Before that, each network only support one instances for publishers. So if you are working with Adcolony, AdMob and Unity, you will have only three instances for those partners, and you can only optimize the three instances. But then with multiple instances, you can create many CPM floors or revenue share instances or direct deals, whatever you want. And you can sell your inventory for a maximum CPM for a different CPM ranges. So it increases the revenue, but it's also increased the operation cost of managing this business. Then in-app bidding comes to the stage, and as you can see, revenue maximized with in-app bidding, because without manually managing all the positions, all the instances, bidding works automatically and find the maximum CPM for you, and then you can sell your inventory with maximum price. And with bidding, it's work on the server side, so you don't need to manage like 80-100 placement and check each instance ad request numbers, adds source response numbers and add fill rates. Without doing manual optimization, we can get maximum out of it. And I will get into technical details with this slide, then we will show how it works to you with a small video. In-app bidding solution starts on the client side. First, when client, when users open the app, mediation SDK starts to work. Then mediation SDK trigger network SDKs, and they send ad requests to server for each user. Then this process happen on the device side, on the user side, on the client side. Then all the requests from the networks goes to the server, where exchange, where all the networks set their bid prices, and then all bid prices get into the auction, and those winner prices and all the auction prices get reformulate the array of the winning CPMs. Then all these bids CPMs combined with the waterfall CPMs that for each impression, for each user, all the bidding network CPMs and the traditional waterfall numbers come into one, and then you can sell your inventory with the maximum prices. So this after the server side, this networks, all the networks cache their ads, and then if they have ad ready for that user, it turns into impression. This is much more basic explanation for how in-app biddings work. How can I play?
Video.
Video. If it doesn't work, no worries. This is also represented in our website. You can check later under the ISCOM bidding section. You can find this video. It's more easy for everyone to understand. So I'm going. But I cannot move. What's the advantage of using bidding? Since bidding helps you to find the maximum CPM for specific user and specific impression, it helps you to maximize your ad revenue without putting too much efforts to make monetization optimization. And it saves you great time, because consider you are working with 10 networks, and you are managing all of them manually. For each network, you will have at least 5 instances, and there will be 50 instances for rewarded. And it will be, with the interstitial, there will be another 50, and it will be 100 instances to manage. But if you are using the bidding, for example, if you are working with the 5 bidders, and it will decrease the half of the time that you are putting into this monetization optimization. And when you are using bidding, it's more efficient for you to use, because normally you will do all of this job manually, but bidding will do it automatically for you. And less latency, it's also an important topic because if you have too many instances, there will be latency within your waterfall and it prevents it to work efficiently. But when you have bidding, all bidding networks come to your waterfall as a bidder and there will be less position and it will be combined for each impression. So without having any latency and with a maximum fill rate around like 98% something, you can monetize your all the traffic. And it's really transparent because yeah, normally on the network side, you need to negotiate for the CPM prices. If you are working manually, you need to ask networks to maximize the fill rate, that position. There are a lot of unknown issues on that angle, but with bidding side, it's going on the server side. Everything is transparent. How much they are bidding, what is the winning CPM, you will have more leverage to see all the data if you are using the bidding. So how you set transition to bidding? This is from our mediation side. I believe it will be more obvious for you to see when I assign all the bidders in one place and the waterfalls in another place. But it's not a separated waterfall actually. This is the hybrid waterfall. We show the bidders in the first section. So all the bidders always first they compete each other on the server side. All the bidders send their CPM and competes to each other. Then these CPM numbers combine with the traditional waterfall on the below. So for each impression, again CPMs arranged by ascending order, descending order. So for each impression, you can sell your traffic to maximum CPM. You need to always use sort by CPM because if you are not using it, then you can sell your traffic to lower CPM if you forgot to keep someone in the above. So sort by CPM help you to arrange the order from top to small. Best practices for hybrid waterfalls. Yeah, we always say. I always suggest my partners to adopt all the available bidders. Yeah, even if their CPMs and the share is not so big, it's always good to have as much as bidders because it helps to increase the competition within bidder networks. So. Not directly, but indirectly, they help to increase the CPM level of bidders, so it's a good thing. You need to remove low share of voice demand sources. Yeah. For example, if someone's share of voice is under the 1% and if their fill rate is under the 1%, you need to remove that because if they're getting traffic and can create some latency and they're not contributing so much, so if you can remove it, then you will give more chance to bidder and the other instances, so it will make your waterfall more compact and increase the efficiency, then it will help you to boost your revenue. So you need to use sort by CPM because if you put some manual overrides, if you do some manual overrides, it will disrupt your waterfall working methodology. So it can decrease your revenue. You need to utilize the rate function for new and updated bidding instances. This is special to us because when you set up a new instance, it's hard to get the right CPM at the start. For example, for AdMob you set $100, but for the first couple of impressions you cannot see $100. So you need to prioritize that position with the rate function, but then we are working with real time. Soon there will be effective CPM on the platform. When you solve it, you need to remove the rate so that waterfall can work in a more efficient way and sort by function. A/B test is important if you have a suggestion to use bidding or integrate a bidder or not. If those are your questions, you can easily do bidding test and see the revenue and R2 differences between bidder networks waterfall and without bidding network waterfalls. Metrics that you need to check. Let's start with the bidding side. On the bidding side, it's important to see how much bid requests you are sending to networks and bid responses, how much they are responding to those bid requests. Their bid rate, bid price, those are important because if the bid rate is really small, there could be some problem or your inventory could not be suitable for that network. So you need to check those metrics. Bid response time is also important. If a network is responding, time is too slow, then you need to remove them because they can also harm your bidding network's performance. On the waterfall side, everyone should focus on the revenue, RPAU, impression in CPM numbers, available trades. You can think as a fill rate at the same time. Those are important metrics because all the things in the hybrid waterfall you want to do is to maximize the return, maximize the ad revenue, maximize the RPAU. So you always check each network performance day by day and also over weekly by checking all of these metrics. And according to those metrics, you need to decide which instances are working good or which networks are working good or not. And you need to optimize your waterfall accordingly. So how to get started building with IOSOS mediation? Yeah, it's really easy. For new ones, you just need to sign up to IOSOS platform, then you will start with the bidding from the day one. And if you are a publisher using the waterfall, you need to configure bidding networks and always we suggest to do some bidding tests to our partners because word is nothing. You need to see the numbers on the platform and understand how valuable could bidding for you. So this is important. And then if you see the impact on the RPU and the operation wise, then you need to increase the bidding traffic on your portfolio and enjoy the increasing revenues. As I said, it's really easy on my resource side. From day one, we started to bid bidding networks. It's really helpful for our publishers. Everyone is happy about it because when we are doing mediation tests, when the client to start using our mediation, they always see a great uplift on the RPA and the revenue numbers. And I believe that it's thanks to the bidding side. And it's also on the SDK side, it's also really stable. We do all the things on the SDK side, update, quick create, and follow the latest technologies. So you don't need to worry about the tech stability. We are covering this side. On IOSOS network, there's a huge amount of bidding networks. As you can see, Adcony, Facebook, Immobi, iResource, MyTarget, Pangle, Sumatra, TechJoy, Wangle, and direct deals and cross promotion. We are working also as bidders. You can use like 11 bidders, and most of the cases, most of the hyperocasional guys. You need to only manually manage like 4 networks. If you consider time saving for you, it's a really meaningful thing because on the monetization side, if you can decrease your monetization operations, then it's also helpful for your revenue. But all at the same time, you can use that time to optimize your user acquisition activities, and which is more competitive area. So you need to stand a stable tech and maximize the revenue and use that time for other side of the business. There is a unique case that this is from last year. Probably in the following weeks we will have another case studies from Turkey. Unico, yes, they were using traditional mode full earlier, and they started to use iron source mediation. Then we advised them to start with the bidding. And they have some hesitation in the first place, but we start with A-B testing, and when they see this uplift on the RPA number, they will love it and expand to all portfolio, and now they are using our technology and the bidding at full capacity. This is all I can say for now. Of course, if you have some more questions, I will be happy to answer or discuss here or in the area. I will be around. So thank you.
Yes. Bu teklif verme süreci teklif vericiler tarafında nasıl işliyor? Onu merak ettim ben. Yani bu verdikleri teklifleri arttırıp azaltmaları veya nasıl ne kadar hızlı buna cevap verebilmeleri yani. Bu nasıl işliyor? Bu süreçten de biraz bahsedebilir misiniz? Teşekkürler.
Ben teşekkür ederim. Okay, ben İngilizce yapacağım. Bidders, when ad request, from the user side, when ad request goes to the bidders on the server side, they check who's the user and what they know about it. And according to that, they check all the demand sources, the advertisers on the area. And if they find a valuable campaign for that user, they say, okay, I can monetize this user with that CPM because they want to show another advertiser ad to it. And according to those or matching on the other side, they update their prices or according to that, they answer the bid request. And since it's on the server side, it's a real time, doing every time. When I open, we send many requests to all the bidders, and in the server side, they always answer simultaneously. One question? Yes, that's it. Okay, let's watch this and then finish. Okay, burada here all the bidders send their CPM numbers, and then you can see waterfall arrange again with the bidder numbers, and this is happening for all of the impressions. So you don't only sell the instance to maximum prices, you sell the impression to maximum prices. So thank you.
Thank you. That was an insightful speech.